BOQ, they've announced the acquisition of ME Bank. Alongside that announcement, BOQ also provided a trading update. I'll just quickly talk about the trading update first so you can understand the picture on a standalone basis. The key point is, on a standalone basis, the outlook for BOQ is improving. So I don't think the acquisition is being used to cover up any standalone issues. The positive themes that we saw in the recent round of major banks reporting, that's come through the trading update with a very strong NIM outcome, a low credit impairment charge. They're growing their home loan book well above system, and the capital position's also looking stronger than expected. So even on a standalone basis, you know, I would have made some significant upgrades to my EPS forecast. With the acquisition, the outlook is looking even better. I think once all the expected cost synergies from this acquisition come through, BOQ can achieve 10% EPS accretion. Now, they're guiding to low double digits to mid-teens EPS accretion. I think they'll come in at the low end of that range on my modelling, so I'm expecting roughly 10% EPS accretion. It looks like it'll take roughly 3 years for all the cost synergies to be realised, and I think they can be realised because ME Bank, as you probably heard me say last week as well, it does look like it's a pretty inefficiently run bank, and what I can see now is that it's been operating with a cost-to-income ratio of 60%. BOQ is inefficient enough in absolute terms, and it's been operating with a cost of income ratio of 54%. I don't think I can see the combined cost of income ratio getting down to about 51% or about 50%. And if that can be achieved, then I think the upper end of BOQ's cost synergies target range can be achieved, and that's what I'm factoring into my forecast. So, on a standalone basis, outlook is looking pretty good, along with the rest of the sector. The earnings outlook's looking good. And this acquisition, I think, could be 10% accretive. There's obviously execution risks that come with such an acquisition. On the tech front, tech integration risk is something to always keep in mind with such integrations. But the advantage here is that both ME Bank and BOQ are using the same core retail banking platform from the same provider as well. So I think that reduces the integration risk. The key risk I'll be keeping an eye on is really that of customer attrition, and you know, to what extent BOQ can retain ME Bank customers. But for the moment, I'm backing BOQ's management team to deliver on this transaction, particularly given that the current CEO, George Frazis, his performance so far has been quite impressive. He's done a pretty good job so far. Good progress in turning around the retail bank, which was in the doldrums when he stepped into BOQ. The dividend outlook for BOQ is also improving, and I've increased my dividend forecast there as well. My target price is increased to $10, and I've upgraded the recommendation to add.